Hey everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In part 2 on the selectives in action, you started a new example and went through the various workflows and functionality specific to the selectives. You also learnt about selective effects and how to apply multiple shaders in one selective. The video concluded in the priority editor when you could rearrange the shader processing pipeline within the selective for a completely different result. Part 3 will pick up from where you left off, and you can either load your saved batch setup from the end of part 2, or follow the steps from the beginning of part 2 to get to this point. You'll now look at the workflow of combining multiple selectives to build even further on VFX or look development. Looking at the examples so far, there is an intense glow on the eyes, but we would like to spread the glow further with less intensity and perhaps a mix of different colors. So you'll use a second selective to enhance the VFX further. Starting in the selective menu, the selective manager indicates that there is only one selective currently in use. You could add more shaders to it, but you'll use a second selective to extend the glowing effect. Now to add another selective to the image object, as before, you could select the surface and add it through the contextual menu via the HUD. Up to this point, that is the only method you have seen in the series so far. However, you can do a lot more with the selective manager. To add a selective, simply click on a number. The 2 goes blue, indicating another active selective. You can also toggle between the two selectives using either the selective manager or the on-screen heads-up display. A couple of things to point out here. Firstly, the default processing pipeline is that selective 1 is applied to the image before selective 2. You can change that, but I'm only stating the default behavior. Secondly, you have up to 48 selectives per object, and you don't need to activate the selectives in order. For example, you could activate selective 1 and then selective 5. This will all be displayed in the selective manager and the HUD. The reason for doing this is that you might develop a method of using certain selectives for specific tasks. Perhaps 1 to 4 is for VFX, and 5 to 20 is for look development. You just need to add the selectives as and when you need them, and they can be slotted in between the other selectives. So this is very flexible. Action will simply process any active selectives within the pipeline and in the order you define. More on that later. Next, I don't know if you noticed that when you activated the second selective, the selective was automatically created with a color-correct selective effects shader. So it's fast to start working, but you might not want this all the time. So to delete the selective and start again, just hold Alt and click on Selective 2. That's how you delete a selective in the Selective Manager. Now to create a selective and go straight to the file browser, hold the Meta or Command key and click on the selective number. So in the browser, you can choose any shader you want to use in the current selective. For example, you could choose Edge Detect and play around with the controls. Note how the model's eyes are glowing, and the Edge Detect is being applied after the glow. Now realistically, you don't need an Edge Detect. What you do need is a duplicate of the first selective that contains the shaders, plus all the masks and tracking you did in the last video. So once more, hold Alt and delete Selective 2. To duplicate a selective using the Selective Manager, select the source, which is Selective 1, hold Shift, and click on the selective to receive the duplicate. In this case, it's Selective 2. The effect on screen is now obviously doubled. So now you're going to tweak the duplicated selective to create a more subtle extended glow from the eyes. Select Selective 1 and press the H keyboard shortcut to hide it. Now select Selective 2 again. Switch to the Bloom Selective Effect shader and Ctrl-click all the values to reset them to the defaults. Next, switch to the Color Correction shader and drag the color wheel towards yellow. Finally, ensure Selective 2 is selected in the HUD and select each mask and extend their softness over most of the eye sockets. So this will serve as the subtle extended glow for the eyes. Select Selective 1 again and unhide it with the H keyboard shortcut. So you can see how you have used one selective to make a constrained glow with a high intensity. The second selective creates a much more subtle effect with a low intensity and the glow is spread out. It's worth mentioning that a shader's strength is controlled through the gradient softness. The effect is more intense at the mask's center, but then tapers off completely as you get to the outer edges of the feathering. This will be looked at in more detail later on in the selective series. Coming back to the workflow of multiple selectives in the image processing pipeline, the grading from the second selective has completely overwhelmed the blue from Selective 1. So Selective 1 should actually come after Selective 2. To rearrange the selective pipeline, you swipe down to the priority editor. In the previous video, you rearranged the shaders within the selective to adjust the processing pipeline. This still applies here, but when you have multiple selectives, you can rearrange them as well. Click Selective 1 and drag it above Selective 2. There is a bottom-up priority, so Selective 2 is now applied first, followed by Selective 1. The blue intense glow is now being applied after the subtle yellow effect. I also want to point out that if you return to the Selective Manager, it does not reflect the new order of the selectives in the processing pipeline. However, if you look at the HUD in the viewport, the processing pipeline does show the correct order of the selectives. Notice that the selective numbers are swapped over, and you're reading the pipeline from left to right. Please save up to this point by saving your batch setup and move on to the next video to continue this example. Next up, you'll use more selectives for a bit of skin smoothing and further look development. Don't forget to also check out the other workflows, features, and enhancements to the Flame 2018.3 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.